that those people that call themselves progressive or woke are not flooding the streets right now in response to Trump declaring he would put these additional sanctions on Iran.
Next up, I'm going to introduce our next speaker. So Lauren Steiner is a grassroots activist and organizer who fights the privatization of public institutions and public goods. She was involved with Occupy LA, started and ran Los Angeles for Bernie Sanders, and was a delegate for him at the Democratic National Convention. She also produces and stars in her own show, The Robust Opposition. She's live streaming for us today. So thank you so much, Lauren Steiner.
Hello, all you beautiful peace lovers. I'm entering my sixth decade opposing war. My very first political act was in 1970, circulating a petition for the McGovern-Hatfield Amendment to end the war in middle school. And it's time for millennials to say, okay, boomer. I protested the first Gulf War in 1990, and over a decade later, I went to my very first MoveOn.org protest to try to stop Bush from invading Iraq. Since then, I've been in front of this very building many times, protesting bombings in Gaza, Syria, and Yemen. And every time I come out, I wonder, why are there not more people here?
Right.
Why in public opinion polls does war and peace and foreign policy in general not higher on lists of people's concerns? And I think that's maybe because war is not seen as a pocketbook issue to most Americans. So it becomes the job of we anti-war activists to not only make the moral case against war and torture and sanctions, but the economic case as well.
That's right.
We spend 50% of our discretionary budget on defense, which is a euphemism because these endless wars are not about our defense. They are about profits for the military-industrial complex and also about countries like Halliburton,
right,
who get contracts to rebuild these countries after we destroy them. This is money that can be going into housing, healthcare, education, and green jobs for our people and people around the world.
Right.
But even when we had a big anti-war movement, and it was estimated that 36 million people took part in 3,000 protests against the Iraq war, we still could not stop George Bush from invading Iraq. So, while we need large and continuous protests, we must not neglect electoral politics.
Right.
So many anti-war groups are cynical about elections, rightly calling out the Democratic Party for these wars just as much as the Republicans.
Right.
After all, Trump was not the first one to commit extrajudicial killings. Every Tuesday, Obama went into the Situation Room and decided who were going to be targeted with drones for targeted killings, another euphemism. And I was a Bernie delegate, as was mentioned, at the Democratic Convention in 2016, where our protest chants were leaked to the Hillary delegates. And when we chanted Black Lives Matter, they were instructed to chant with us. But when we chanted No More War, they were told to chant over us, USA, USA. And it was chilling. I had to wonder when opposing wars left the platform of the Democratic Party. That's the chant that they shout at Trump rallies.
That's right.
Even though the parties are no different, we cannot give up on electoral politics. We are here today because the elected president of the United States did this heinous act. Now, personally, I think impeachment is too easy on him. I think he should be prosecuted for war crimes at the International Court in The Hague. But since we cannot count on that happening, We must make sure that he is defeated in November. And the best person to do that,
Bernie.
The person who inspires the most enthusiasm, and the person who also happens to have the best anti-war platform, is Bernie Sanders.
That's right, Bernie!
You know, Stephen, I think about the modern history of this country, and I remember Vietnam. That was my generation. And I remember the war in Iraq. Those are the two worst foreign policy blunders in the modern history of this country. And both of those wars were built on lies. Both of those wars, which caused such incredible suffering in our country, 59,000 American soldiers dead as a result of the Vietnam War, probably more died even after they came back, a generation really enormously impacted. The war in Iraq, 4,500 of our people, hundreds of thousands of Iraqis dead. We spend trillions of dollars that should be invested in healthcare, in education, in infrastructure.
He protested the Vietnam War. He was a conscientious objector. He spoke out against Reagan's incursions into Central America in the 80s. He voted against the Iraq War. He was one of only two senators to vote against the sanctions on Iran, Russia, and Venezuela in 2017. And that was a very unpopular position to take. He's voted against war budgets, and he authored a bipartisan bill last year that passed both houses of the Congress to defund Saudi Arabia for committing war crimes in Yemen.
Right.
He was the first to call the killing of Soleimani an assassination.
Right.
And he did not call him a murderous terrorist responsible for thousands of deaths. Soleimani was a military leader of a country, and sadly, that's what militaries do. As president, Bernie will preference diplomacy over war and will listen to people like his current foreign policy advisor, Matt Duss, not Mike Pompeo, who I read in CNN today has been wanting to take out Soleimani for 10 years.
I have to say that I know it is not sexy to talk about diplomacy. It is not sexy to talk about making sure that we have a great State Department with people who know the culture and the language of countries all over the world. I've met some of these people all over. They do a great job. It ain't sexy. It is much more powerful. It's better TV to talk about how we're going to kill this one and kill that one. But I believe the American people are sick and tired of endless wars. They want to improve lives for the American people. So I will do everything that I can to stop a war with Iran that I think will be a disaster. I have introduced legislation which would prevent spending, giving Trump one nickel of money to go to war in Iran. And there's another good piece of legislation that once again would bring up the War Powers Act to make sure that he could not go to war unless he had the authorization of the Congress.
Bernie will cut the military budget in half and fund programs that benefit people and the planet.
Yes.
His number one rated Green New Deal plan will spend $16.3 trillion on the climate crisis, and that's $13 trillion more than the next candidate. And because of this great plan and his longtime commitment to this issue, he won the endorsement of the Sunrise Movement today.
Politician, a president gets up there, we're going to be tough. And these are evil guys. We're going to go to war. Wow, and your poll ratings go up. And then people say, well, wait a minute. You know, what are the unintended consequences of that? Well, how many people are going to die? How much is it going to cost us? Oh, candidate X or Congressman X is soft on terror. 30-second ad. Congressman, you know, X, he doesn't want to protect America. All right? And I really get very angry at that approach. Because we sit in the Congress in our beautiful rooms, beautiful studio over here, and we do not know what war is about. I met with the mothers of the young men who lost their lives in that war, met with the wives, met with the kids. I met with the soldiers who came back without arms and legs, who are dealing with PTSD today. War is a horror. And it's time politicians understood that we have got to do everything humanly possible to avoid war.
The California primary is March 3rd. If Bernie wins California, which has the most delegates of all the states, there is a very good chance he will win the nomination. Woo! So, if you want to stop these endless wars, get into the streets, of course, but also vote for Bernie Sanders.
Right, yes.
Now, you can sign up to volunteer for him at our table over there. He will need all of our help to beat the wealthy and powerful corporate interests, all of which are allied against him for his entire platform. Not only is he taking on the war industry, he's taking on the fossil fuel industry and the pharmaceutical industry, big agriculture, you name it. So, thank you, and keep working for peace.
That's right.
Thank you so much.